Thanks for joining me on Playing with Rain. I have a very fun and exciting experiment today, and we're going to make some snow, and this is the type of snow your kids can play with any time of the year. To make this instant snow, all you need is some baking soda, some water, and a bowl to mix it into. It's very, very simple. So let's go ahead and get started making that snow. First, you're going to want to start with your baking soda. Now, if you're like me and you like the snow to feel real and to actually be cold like snow would outside in an Arctic blizzard, then you might want to put your baking soda in the freezer an hour or two before you do this experiment. If you don't put it in the freezer, that's fine too. The texture of the snow will still be the same. It just won't feel as cold. So I'm going to go ahead and pour some of this. I recommend about 4 cups, but you don't have to use that much. In fact, I'll probably use a little bit less because my bowl here might not hold quite that much anyway. So, and you don't really need a lot, but if you have a few kids that want to play in this, you might want to make a little bit more just so they can have enough to have some fun with. I did have a couple boxes here, so I'm going to just add a little bit more of this second box. And then we're just going to add water until it gets to the right consistency. And just like in the real world, in the world of weather, the consistency of your snow is going to depend on the water content of that snow. If you have a lot of water, it'll be more slushy. If there's not as much water to work with, it's going to be more of that dry kind of powdery snow. So I'm going to go ahead and just start mixing this in here a little bit. You can use a spoon or a whisk. I find it easier to just kind of use my hands and just have some fun with it. So I'm going to do that. As I've started pouring in the water, I'm going to just dive in there, and it is cold. I can tell you that it totally feels like snow because I did just pull this baking soda right out of the freezer right before this video. So it's cold on my fingers. Almost recommend gloves if you don't like the cold. To me, it kind of feels nice. I don't mind it, but I'm going to add a little bit more water because it is still a little more powdery for my liking. If I was going skiing or snowboarding on this, it'd be perfect, but I want to make a really nice snowball or a snowman. So I'm going for more of that kind of slushy, real wet, good snow that's good for packing a snowman or a snowball. And it's starting to get there. In fact, you can see it now. Look at that. I have made a snowball. It's kind of a smaller one, but a nice little snowball. It's easy to put together. And I can make a couple more, but that's really a pretty good consistency. I could add more water. It would just get really, really slushy and messy. So I think I'll stop to about this point here so that it's a good packing snow. And that's basically it. That's as simple as it is to make snow. But if you do want to add a little bit of a twist, which I like to do, you can add some vinegar and some food coloring to the mix. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And we're going to make it a little bit more fun. So what I did here is now to make things more interesting. I pull out this tray to make it a little bit easier to collect the mess. And this bottle is just some vinegar. I poured some vinegar in there. And I did add a couple drops of blue food coloring. Now, I can go ahead and start with my base of my snowman. And I can build. I'm terrible at building snowmen, by the way. I'm sure your kids and you will be a lot better at this than I will be. But you get the idea, hopefully. Gonna build this. So, little snowman. Not the most proportional snowman I have ever built. But there it is. Used up most of my snow. If you wanted to, you could add some little candy, stuff like that, to make eyes and mouth and stuff like that for the snowman and some little arms. But I'm just going to simply leave it as a plain old snowman. And then I'm going to use this vinegar that I've colored with some blue food coloring to make more of a fizzy experiment here. We're going to make our snowman melt. Now the sun's coming out, it's warming up, and things are starting to heat up and get a little bit warm. And you can see that our snowman is starting to sizzle a little bit in the sun. He's getting pretty warm. And there he goes. He just tipped over. He's no longer really a snowman anymore. So just kind of a fun way to do it. I really enjoy this one. Very, very simple. The science behind it is similar to many other experiments that involve baking soda and vinegar, where you get that reaction and it starts to release release the carbon in that reaction, and you get more of that fizzing action going on. So that's kind of the reaction you're seeing as you put the vinegar spraying onto the snowman that we've built. But really, in the real world, as far as snow goes, it's a little bit different, of course. We don't just make snow in our house that we can play with as easily. If we really want that real authentic snow, you have to wait for those cold days to bundle the kids up and go outside and play with it. But how that works in the real world is you get real small, tiny ice crystals that build upon each other. And once those ice crystals build upon each other and get heavy enough to fall from the clouds, they'll fall as snowflakes. And as long as the air is cold enough all the way to the surface of the earth, then it will stay as snow as it falls to the ground. Now, some people have asked me, and this is a common question, well, how cold does it have to be for it to snow? And the answer actually is a bit surprising. If you want snow to stick on the ground, it does have to be at or below 32 degrees Fahrenheit or 0 degrees Celsius for it to stick to the ground. But snow can fall in the air even if it's 50 degrees. I personally have actually seen that growing up in northern Arizona, where it was about 50 degrees and there was snowflakes falling from the sky. That happens a lot of times if you have a very dry air mass in place and the air is cold enough to support that above the ground, because all it takes is about 1,000 feet of air above freezing to start melting snowflakes. But if the air, that layer of air above the ground, is a lot thinner than that 1,000 foot mark, then snowflakes can fall fast enough through the air, even if it's above freezing, and they won't melt before touching the ground. So kind of an interesting thing there. But there's more science to learn about this. We have a little bit more information on our website. You can check out playingwithrain.com. We go a little bit more in depth on the science behind these experiments. But I hope you enjoyed this. Hopefully you learned something about this and learned how to make some snow, maybe have some fun, if nothing else. And please, if you do like this, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of our videos, our experiments that we do in the future as well. And I'd love to hear your feedback. You can comment below. You can also find us on social media. Leave some comments. Let us know if there's other experiments you'd like us to try. We would love some of those ideas and love to give those a shot as well. Thanks again, and we'll see you next time.